crazy things you didn't know about Juice WRLD.
Really sh- rope.
Prior to his passing, Juice WRLD was on his way to becoming one of the next greats in hip hop. While many knew the rapper in the eye of the public, his life behind closed doors may come as quite the shock. Welcome to Lime Report. Before we begin, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, and check out the link in the description to enter a chance at winning our Apple product giveaway. When news of Juice WRLD's tragic passing first broke, the world was devastated. His death came on the heels of both XXXTentacion and Mac Miller passing away in 2018. With another artist dead in 2019, people began to see the epidemic of young artists losing their lives. Part of Juice WRLD's charm was his unapologetic honesty. Those who listened to his music were often taken to the darkest realms of the young rapper's mind, as he often confessed of the deep pain and emotional trauma he felt throughout his life. While the rapper spoke his truths on his tracks, it turns out Juice WRLD wasn't revealing everything about himself. Thanks for joining us, everyone. Today, we'll be taking a look at the wonderful life and tragic death of the young Chicago star. Stay with us as we reveal some of Juice WRLD's deepest secrets. You won't want to miss this. Juice WRLD's career came out of nowhere, some would say. His parents split when he was just 3 years old, and with his dad gone, he and his brother were left to be raised by his single mother, a devout Christian. Juice WRLD's mom despised rap and forbade him from listening to any form of it growing up. Thanks to that, Juice WRLD grew up instead listening to pop and rock and was heavily influenced by artists like Green Day and Panic at the Disco. After being introduced to rap by his cousin in high school, Juice WRLD fell in love with the genre and began listening to it behind his mother's back. Although Juice was enamored by the overall vibe of rap, there was something about the music that he just couldn't connect to. Juice WRLD suffered from mental health issues and subsequently dealt with anxiety and depression. As he explored rap, he realized there was a huge gap in the genre and made it his mission to fill that void. When Juice WRLD began recording music, rather than mimicking the work of those before him, the brazen young star decided to take a different route and instead wrote impassioned lyrics full of frankness and vulnerability. Prior to Juice WRLD, rap focused solely on the ego, how much one could take and how hard one could flex. Yet rappers like Juice WRLD turned their backs on what was considered traditional rap and instead ushered in a new emo rap that allowed those who felt pain to be able to connect to their favorite rappers on a deeper level. "Everybody's got pain," he said when interviewed by The Guardian. "Depression, addiction, heartbreak, these are human characteristics." As the rapper was no stranger to heartache, he decided that rather than bandage the pain with drugs and money, it was better instead to open up about the terrible things in his life in order to let his fans know that they were not alone. In his quest to define true human characteristics in his music, Juice WRLD was able to release 2 full-length albums, 2 mixtapes, and countless EPs before his death. Juice WRLD's career was born on SoundCloud, where the young artist took his inspiration from early 2000 heartbreak rock and combined it with his new love in hip-hop. Juice, who grew up idolizing Kurt Cobain as much as Kanye West, knew that in order to find the sound he was looking for, he would have to make it himself. The task would have proved far too difficult for most others, but thanks to his mother's background in the church, Juice was able to benefit by learning the piano from her and then going on to learn a total of 4 instruments. Thanks to his fiery passion and extensive musical background, Juice was perfectly placed to join the likes of Philadelphia rapper Lil Uzi Vert in making emo rap famous. Juice WRLD began to develop his sound in 2013 during his first year of high school. After working on music for some time, he released his first track, Forever, under the name Juice the Kid. Although many have assumed his name came from his love for coding at a young age, it was actually inspired by his love for Tupac Shakur's role in the film Juice. He later decided to change his name because to him it represented taking over the world, a goal of his he planned to accomplish through his music. As the popularity of his newfound genre grew, so too did Juice WRLD's career to the brink of superstardom. Following his signing to Grade A, a subsidiary of Interscope and fellow Chicago rappers G-Herbo and Lil Bibby's imprint, Juice WRLD released his debut album, Goodbye and Good Riddance, in May 2018. The album debuted at number 4 on the Billboard 200 and was certified platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America. Soon after, he found himself entertaining arenas with the likes of Nicki Minaj and recorded a collaborative album with his idol, Future, heavyweight artist that Juice WRLD was primed to join the ranks of. Building on his success, the rapper released his second album, Death Race for Love, which, after a week at number 2 on the charts, finally made his way to the number 1 spot. The album struck a chord with its tormented auto-tuned melodies and immersive melancholy moods, further highlighting his unique style. Following the commercial success of his sophomore album, there seemed to be somewhat of a fissure created among the community over the emo rap genre. To some, Juice WRLD and his peers provided a positive outlet for young listeners to be able to express themselves. Those opposed, however, claim that rather than provide an outlet, Juice WRLD's illusion of self-harm and drug use as coping mechanisms was actually worsening the growing opiate problem among teens rather than helping to solve it. Soon, the genre and all associated acts were no longer celebrated by the public and were accused of glorifying drug use by the DEA following the death of the Long Beach rapper Lil Peep and troubling increases in opioid use by teenagers. When the public began accusing Juice WRLD and those around him of worsening the growing opiate pandemic, he was quick to defend his music by reminding everyone of his rights to free speech. According to The Star, his music was not meant to be taken as a way to promote drugs, and rather, he sang about his addiction as a way to clear his mind and relieve his stresses. Yet ironically, his drug dependency can actually be traced to an artist who, after his death, had the same thing to say about his own music, Future. Following Juice WRLD's death, the relationship between drugs and rap were once again brought to question, and the world's first target was the Atlanta-based superstar. Juice WRLD discovered Future as a kid, and after listening to his music, decided to try lean in the sixth grade, which ultimately led to his spiraling drug addiction. While Future isn't the first artist to sing about drugs, even he himself has said that he may have brought more attention to drugs thanks to his cadence and charisma. When asked if he felt any guilt after Juice WRLD had passed, Future admitted that it was a touchy situation, but added, "Me having an influence on that, I just feel like that's not my intention. My intention was just to be me. I'm just being me, and what you get from it is what you get from it. I wouldn't want no one to go through anything to harm themselves or bring death to themselves, and Juice WRLD is a touchy situation. I'm heartbroken by the whole thing. My heart goes out to his family, his mom." Just as Future believed that he was only being himself and was not responsible for the fallout of those who followed in his path, so too did Juice WRLD before his passing. However, since Juice WRLD's death, this point of irony has sparked an even larger debate on the issue. Since his death, members of his friends and family have all done their part to honor him, and his mother, Carmela Wallace, announced last week that she created the Live Free 999 Fund. Despite his insane success in just a short time, Juice WRLD struggled greatly with mental health and turned to drugs as a way to cope. In honor of her son, his mother decided to create the organization as a way to normalize the conversations around addiction, anxiety, and depression in underprivileged communities. Young people around the world were truly touched by Jared's music because he spoke to issues and situations in his music that resonated with them so deeply, said Wallace. I made the decision upon his death that I was going to share his struggles with the world with the objective of helping others. It is my desire to help those who are hurting by providing access to education, prevention, and treatment for opioid and other forms of drug addiction. It is my hope that Live Free 999 will help people just as Jared's music has and will continue to touch lives for years to come. While his mother was a devout Christian and did not approve of his music, she understood the pain that her son felt and knew that the music he created was his way of being able to relieve himself of the scars. The hip-hop community was stunned by the news that Juice WRLD had passed away, and since his death, his loved ones are still piecing together their lives following such a tragedy. The 21-year-old star died after suffering a seizure reportedly brought on by oxycodone and codeine, causing a ripple effect of his rap peers pledging to quit using drugs. Following his death, many news outlets claimed that the rapper had eerily predicted his own death, but what they failed to mention was the rapper's full discography. Unlike some of his peers, Juice WRLD was fully aware of his impending death and also knew that if he continued to live as he had, that he would have met the same fate as some of the artists that have died too soon before him. Although his life and budding career were cut short, the impact he made on hip-hop will be remembered for generations to come. Juice WRLD was an intelligent and driven young man. Had he survived his unfortunate overdose, the rapper likely would have found himself at the pinnacle of rap in just a few short years at the rate he was going. But it's like Juice WRLD himself said, "What's the 27 Club? We ain't making it past 21. While we're unsure what will become of Juice WRLD's legacy as more artists begin to denounce drugs, we hope his name will be remembered as one who struggled and lost, but fought with all his might in the war against addiction. What do you think Juice WRLD will be most remembered for? Will he be forever blamed as a spark in the growing pandemic? Or did his music help those suffering to find their voice? Thanks for joining us on Lime Report, everyone. Make sure to let us know what you think in the comment section below. And before you go, be sure to leave a like, subscribe, and check out the link in the description to enter a chance at winning our Apple product giveaway.
feel like it was still legal. I'm dumb enough to go in the store and steal, so I'm dumb enough to ask for a date with Lauryn Hill.
It depends, man. Like, some bands do it live. Like, we did a record, our second record, we did it like live band because we were trying to be the Beatles and shit. Then, like,
some people only see that I'm white, ignoring skill, because I stand out like a green hat with an orange bill, but I don't get pissed.